Department official, David Tafuri. Great to see both of you. Before we get into this immigration plan, David, you were watching Vicente Fox, a former president of Mexico for 6 years. What were your thoughts on that?
Well, you guys didn't agree on very much. I thought you had a very interesting line of questioning, which is pointing out that when he was president of Mexico, they only legalized 15,000 immigrants, and they deported hundreds of thousands of immigrants. That's not really consistent with his criticism of the U.S., and I didn't think he explained that very well. But I do think some of his criticisms about President Trump are accurate.
Jason, Vicente Fox has pretty much called Donald Trump everything in the book, every name in the book. And I think in calling Trump rude, and you respond by being even more rude, I didn't think that was all that convincing.
No, I think he's been childish at best over the first year. To not acknowledge the success that Donald Trump has had as president of the United States is just inaccurate. But I thought it was interesting, his take on the wall. You know, you don't see, I think his opposition to the wall and building a fence is the fact that it will actually work. I think people like Vicente Fox are actually okay with human trafficking. I think they're okay with the moving of drugs because it's good for the economy of Mexico. And the fact that the wall, fact of the matter is, the wall works. They don't actually want to solve that problem.
Well, they want the criminals to come. When Trump said they're sending their criminals, the people who come through Guada and El Salvador, MS-13 from Salvador, you think they want them hanging out in Cabo? I don't think so.
Push them
they
through,
want them
push
going
them
up to California, which they
and,
do.
And look, and there's nobody that's trying to break into Mexico from the United States.
No,
it's
one
way move. Yeah.
All right. Let's
exactly.
Let's go to the immigration plan by the White House, because this has really surprised a lot of people. Yeah. Congressman, 1.8 million people getting amnesty, a jump from 1 million from last week, already getting favorable reviews from some of the more open borders Republican types. But I'm getting pinged with text after text, people saying, how is Trump negotiating against himself here? What's your reaction?
Three of the 4 points I'm okay with, but the special pathway to citizenship, absolutely not. That's not what he campaigned on. It's not what he promised. It's not something, if I were still in Congress, that I could vote for and support. I'm okay with a legal status, but I don't think I think they should get in line like everybody else. And you know who we're not serving? The people that are forgotten. The people who weren't willing to break the law, the people who are trying to come here legally and lawfully, the people who have been waiting in line, those are the people we have been failing. I don't think they should get a special pathway to citizenship. Not one person, let alone 1.8 million of them.
And David, Nancy Pelosi, I don't think we have the full screen, but Nancy Pelosi has already come out blasting it as blatantly anti-immigrant. She just went on and on and on. We do have it. Oh, great. The 50% cut to legal immigration in the framework and the recent announcements to end temporary protected status for Central Americans and Haitians are both part of the same cruel agenda. They are part of the Trump administration's unmistakable campaign to make America white again. Oh, isn't she lovely? I think we need to update that photo to make it more recent, by the way. What's your reaction to that? I mean, look, come on, 1.8 million from Donald Trump, and she's calling it like a white supremacist proposal? She's off her rocker meds or whatever it is. I don't know what it is.
We didn't know what Trump was going to do. He's come out with a compromise that I think is reasonable. Some Democrats are not going to like it, clearly, as you heard from Pelosi and other leaders. Some Republicans, hardline Republicans, don't like it either. The compromise that they reached is they are going to have a pathway for citizenship for Dreamers. That's important.
More than
in
Dreamers.
In exchange, they're going to have a lot of money for the wall and border security. Some Democrats don't like that, but that's a reasonable thing for Democrats to give up in exchange for the Dreamers. Now, there are 803,000 Dreamers right now. As you pointed out, 1.8 million could get into this program, but they have to apply. So they're not all immediately going to become on the pathway to legal citizenship under this deal. They have to apply. But it is interesting that Trump has extended, almost expanded, the ability of people to be in the Dreamer program. That was unexpected, but this is the trade-off. Democrats aren't going to like that I'm saying this, but I think it's a good deal.
And I think that it's probably the best deal that they can put forth to get the votes that they need, to get 60 votes. I mean, like it or not, that's probably the only thing they're going to get 60 votes for, and I bet they've been doing the numbers. But for Nancy Pelosi to call it basically white supremacist, you just lose all credibility on that, complete. Jason, before we let you go, up or down, will this thing be acceptable to the House of Representatives?
I think it might pass because you probably get all of the Democrats. If they unite and get behind it, then you get the squishy middle and they get to the numbers they need.
So Trump delivers amnesty to almost 2 million people. Wow. Gentlemen.